we all want the ocean to look like this, right? Well, it's starting to look more like this. Here's why. There are a lot of factors that have contributed to this image, like pollution and oil spills. If we're being completely honest, preventing pollution and oil spills is increasingly difficult with global industrialization. This is why I want to focus on shark finning. Fixing the shark finning problem is tangible in one specific area that humans have a lot of control over. We, as people, did this. How did this all start? According to Britannica, this practice is thought to have started in China in about 1000 AD, primarily for the purpose of supplying fins for shark fin soup, which was served to guests at social occasions where the dish is symbolic of the host's status. Roughly 100 million sharks are killed every year, and this is the largest factor responsible for the 70% decline in shark populations globally over the past 50 years. Here's why this matters. We don't know what would happen if the ocean had no sharks, but is that a risk we want to take? Here's what we know. Sharks are apex predators, so they regulate the populations of smaller fish. Side note, this version of a food web is oversimplified, but stick with me here. In the ocean, the big fish, sharks, eat the medium-sized fish. The medium-sized fish eat the small fish, and the small fish eat plankton and algae. If we erase the sharks, the medium-sized fish eat all of the little fish because there's no one to regulate the medium fish. Then, there are no little fish to eat the algae. So, we get this. Also, sharks eat rays, and rays eat scallops. With no sharks, rays eat all the scallops, which is bad for the rays, the scallops, and all of us who like to eat them. Do you see how species of animals start to disappear and the ocean's ecosystem becomes unhealthy? We need sharks, and they need us. Now, this isn't completely one-sided. Earlier I said, we are the problem. And we are. Culturally, we are responsible for a lot of this. The media gives sharks a terrible reputation. Shark horror movies like Jaws and 47 Meters Down show sharks in a negative light, which is completely unrealistic. Just so you know, you have a higher chance of being struck by lightning, killed by a pig, or killed by a vending machine than being killed by a shark. So, what do we do about shark finning? Sharks are actually expensive because they attract tourism. A shark in Palau costs $2 million. I don't know if $2 million is the right number, but the penalty for killing a shark needs to be enough to threaten the fishing industry. So, why don't we make the culprits pay for it? Trust me, I can't think of a single fishing company that can afford to pay $2 million for each shark it kills. And that is the point. If we play this right, protecting living sharks will benefit the tourism industry, which allows more people to see them and appreciate them. Here's what you can do about it. Look, money talks. Boycott shark movies and stop buying shark products. Also, communicate with local legislators because we need to create more local, national, and global laws to stop the killing. Remember, we're the problem, but we're also the solution. We can make this better.